Hello, and welcome to the Gallon Junction Railway Museum. This tape will guide you through the various exhibits displayed within the main museum building. Before we begin, a brief history of the museum site. The area in which we are standing was once the site of the Gallon Junction Motive Power Depot, home to a small allocation of locomotives operating services for both the Dark Railways line to Mearcombe and working local commuter trains to Barbourne, Horton, Colhapper and Market Labourer. The site once hosted a free road engine shed, carriage and wagon sidings, a coal stage and water tower, and the Ransom and Rapier 70-foot turntable, now relocated to Colhapper Motive Power Depot. The depot was redeveloped multiple times during its operational history, but unfortunately, an act of arson in 1969 completely destroyed the complex, taking three of the Dark Railway's locomotives with it. The site was redeveloped during the early 1970s, when the Dark Railway's Southern Terminus and motive power requirements were relocated to nearby Colhapper. The redeveloped site is also shared by the extensive railway works of Carcass Smash Limited, as well as the Dark Railway's own carriage and wagon works. The museum was built to not only educate visitors to the railway, but also to store out-of-use locomotives and rolling stock securely. We hope you enjoy this tour of the Gallon Junction Railway Museum. Please proceed to the left-hand side of the museum, nearest to the railway station, where our tour will begin. Our first exhibit includes recovered items from the three locomotives lost during an act of arson in 1969, which completely destroyed the site of the original Gallon Junction Motive Power Depot, allocation code 77A. The three locomotives were London Midland and Scottish Railway Fowler 3F shunting tank number 47407, of which the smoke box number plate can be seen here, Industrial Shunting Diesel number D2992, and British Railways Type 1 Diesel number D8198, of which their builder's plates survive. The entirety of this museum is dedicated to the memory of these lost locomotives. This pair of tank engines were ordered and built for the Dark Railway by Hawthorne Leslie in 1893 and were the first steam locomotives used on the railway. Numbered 1 and 2, they were eventually named after the founder of the railway, Lord Theodore Dark, and his son, Lord Nathaniel Dark. Both shunting engines were originally allocated to Gallon Junction Motive Power Depot and were used to operate the quarry sidings at Somer Quarry. The tank engines are currently painted in Dark Railway black, lined out with blue and white lining, but carry two different emblems, with number 1, Theo, having the full Dark Railway lettering applied, whilst number 2, Otto, has the modern day shortened DR logo applied. This is an example of a general plank van used for transporting various goods around the Dark Railway network. Built in 1925, this particular van was primarily in use with Hertz Bob and Sons Furnishings of Mearcombe, transporting raw materials from Colhapper to Mearcombe Industrial Estate, where assembly and processing would take place to construct various items of home furnishings. The van was later in use transporting perishable traffic to the mainline. This van was originally stored out of use at Mearcombe Motive Power Depot for many years, before being cosmetically restored for display in the museum. Our next exhibit includes three of the Dark Railway's various standard open goods wagons, which were used for a variety of jobs around the railway line. The first wagon, number 141140, is an example of a standard ballast wagon used for the export of high-quality ballast rock and shingle extracted from Somer Quarry, and often used in track maintenance, not only for the Dark Railway, but also for other railway lines within the region. This wagon is preserved in standard Dark Railway goods green. The next wagon was the final seven plank wagon purchased by the Dark Railway as late as 1965, and was used to transport locomotive coal to the motive power depots around the railway, often originating from the coal mining operations at Somer. It's been preserved in excellent condition, having only been used for around 6 years before being replaced by larger iron hoppers for these duties. The final wagon in this exhibit is the only surviving example of rolling stock from Prairie Coaling Limited of Mirkoon, a well-known coal processing company that once operated from the heart of the industrial estate at Mirkoon. The company folded operations during 1966, and the wagon was sold to the Dark Railway for locomotive coal haulage. Restored to Prairie Coaling Limited's striking purple livery, this well-restored wagon is a shining example of a private owner wagon. This small 10-ton brake van was originally ordered by the Southern Railway in 1929 and built at their Ashford Works to a standard diagram. Despite its small size, this brake van would have been instrumental in controlling goods trains as they descended inclines all over the network. Purchased originally by the Dark Railway in 1947, just after the Second World War, the van was used as a brake vehicle for ballast traffic originating from Soma Quarry, and would have been used as an internal traffic vehicle, being restricted for use on the Dark Railway's metals as far as Gallen Junction, where it would have been marshalled onto an empty train returning to the quarry. After many years out of traffic at Soma, and in a dilapidated state, the van was purchased by the Dark Railway Preservation Society and restored to working order, used with the Society's track maintenance trains until relocated to the museum upon its opening. This impressive railway-mounted gun was saved by the Dark Railway in 1969 and has an interesting local history. The original gun was of 14 inches, named Scene Shifter, and originally constructed for use with the Japanese battleship Yamashiro, but later repurposed and mounted on railway carriages as a railway gun in 1918. It was deployed to France upon completion and used for long-range attacks upon German forces, being manoeuvred on curved sections of railway track to aim. Upon returning to the United Kingdom, the railway gun sat out of use, and in 1928, the original gun barrel was removed and scrapped. During the Second World War, the railway carriages were used to mount this 13.5-inch gun barrel, with the entire mounting and gun being officially named HMG Scene Shifter. The gun and its associated ammo van were deployed in coastal defences, being used on the nearby Kolhapa to Barbourne line, being stored in the disused second portal of the railway tunnels at Kolhapa when not in use. After the war ended, the gun and ammunition van were stored and bricked up inside the tunnel as a safety measure in case a weapon was ever re-entered into service if another war were to break out. However, by the late 1960s, the government had realised that there was no need for such a large rail-mounted weapon, and the gun was initially tendered for scrapping. However, the Dark Railway, realising its historic properties, purchased both the gun and the ammunition van and cosmetically restored them in First World War camouflage livery for display within the museum. Both are still able to be deployed for demonstration operations and are often brought out of the museum for wartime events on the railway. Various general goods vans such as this were built for War Department use during the Second World War, and would have been used to transport a wide variety of loads between different military camps, from general supplies to construction materials and weapons. This particular example was used to transport military perishables and ration between the various military establishments in the Kent area, keeping our soldiers supplied with food during one of the hardest times in history. The van was acquired from the War Department by the Dark Railway, once considered obsolete, and continued to be used to transport consumable goods primarily to Soma, where rail transport was key to supplying the isolated village, as the road networks in the area were, and still are, considered to be rather poor. The van had been restored to its War Department guise as number 47863. This next exhibition shows two examples of flatbed wagons used to transport heavy military loads during both world wars of this century. The first of these is a northeastern built example, numbered 55093, built for use during the First World War, whilst the second, Southern Railway built Warwell number WW14 were built during the Second World War. Both were used for the transportation of military vehicles, such as army lorries, armoured cars, and of course, tanks. Both wagons are seen here carrying an example of era-appropriate tanks, kindly loaned to us by the War Memorial Museum of Kent. Number 55093 has been restored to North Eastern Railway grey, whilst WW4 carries standard army green as used whilst requisitioned by the government during hostilities. This 12-inch railgun was originally built by the Elswick Ordnance Company in 1917 as an example of their Mark V howitzer railgun for operation on the continent during the First World War. However, this particular example was never used in active service and was subsequently stored out of use at Folkestone Harbour for potential repurpose by the British Navy. It is unclear of the gun's history from this point forward. All that is known is that the gun somehow ended up on the Dark Railway, being rediscovered at Somer during the late 1940s, and subsequently remained there on display until the Gallen Junction Railway Museum was established. The gun has come to be known as the Tau Cannon, though again, the reason for this and where the name came from are still unknown to our researchers. This Southern Railway van was built in 1933 to the Van B specification for use with passenger traffic on the Southern's network. This type of bogey van was used as a luggage vehicle for holiday traffic to and from the coasts, including use with such name trains as the Knight Ferry and Golden Arrow. The design was larger than other similar designs and featured bogies rather than standard axles used on other diagrams of luggage van. Purchased for use on the Dark Railway during the 1950s, the vehicle was later loaned to the Infant Dark Railway Preservation Society as a storage vehicle whilst they worked on restoring Gallen Junction Railway Station after several years of neglect. One of many such vans purchased by the railway, this one, being in the poorest condition, was cosmetically restored for display in the museum, complete with new wooden frames and restored running gear. This locomotive is the most modern form of motive power displayed within the museum. Numbered D208, upon completion in 1958, this locomotive was originally allocated to York, operating as part of British Railways' pilot scheme for diesel traction. Proving to be a decent performer, the locomotive operated on express passenger services for many years. However, during 1966, the locomotive was equipped with an experimental turbocharger of a non-standard design, hampering its reliability. Not wanting to waste resources rectifying the problem plaguing the locomotive, was withdrawn from service and later sold to the Dark Railway, which at this point was searching for engines to run the ill-fated mainline charter to the capital. Unfortunately, on its first day in service on the railway, the experimental turbocharger failed whilst the engine climbed Upway Bank, having to be rescued by diesel locomotive number D8198. After this, D208 was inspected and found to be riddled with faults, including the non-standard turbocharger. Hence, once the locomotive had been fully refurbished and repaired, it began carrying the name Turbo, as a homage to the circumstances of its early preservation. After several years of reliable operation, D208 suffered another mechanical setback, and, wishing to give the locomotive a well-deserved rest, it was placed into the museum as an example of modern traction and the untimely withdrawal of such machines by the government-controlled railways. Our next exhibit has been grouped into a typical Southern Railway freight train. Of the four grouped railway companies of the United Kingdom, the Southern Railway and its constituents were never the largest freight carriers, being much more invested in passenger traffic in and out of the capital and long-distance traffic to the holiday resorts and ports of the south of England. Despite the early adoption of electrification and suburban passenger traffic, freight operations were still important, especially to the large ports such as Southampton. displayed here are wagons once belonging to the Southeastern and Chatham Railway, the company in charge of the initial building of the main line that the Dark Railway originally connected to. Shown here are examples of a Dadshall Brake, number 55461, a Maunsell General Goods Van, number 45636, two small container flat wagons for use with smaller loads, number 39221 and 3338, five plank open wagon, number 3083, and Queen Mary Bogie Brake Van, number S56389. Of special note of this exhibit is the Canadian-built 1937 Chrysler Imperial, owned by Mr. Edgar von Braun of New Wessex Island, and kindly loaned to the museum and part of this display. Built in 1885 at Oak End Locomotive Works, Dexby West and Bexford Joint Railway, No. 3, is an example of a standard shunting tank engine built as part of the Dexby Built Locomotive Initiative. This class of engine, much like other engines built under this initiative, were manufactured using kits of parts supplied by Gorton Works, based on patterns for small outside frame steam locomotives once used on the Manchester, Sheffield and Lincolnshire Railway. This engine is part of a class of seven locomotives built between 1885 and 1886 for use on the Dexby West and Bexford Joint Railway, and were commonly seen in use for shunting, local passenger trains and trip freights. All other members of the class are still in running order at the nearby Dexby Railway, who have generously loaned locomotive number 3 for display within our museum, as part of a renewed cooperation between the two once rival railway companies. It is expected that number 3 will be restored at Caracas Smash Limited at some point in the future. Our next exhibit showcases a pair of similar, yet very different, kinds of steam traction engine built for agricultural and industrial use. The first is an example of a road-going steam traction engine, which was designed to be used hauling heavy loads on public roads, but could also be used off-road for use on farmland. Our example was built by Charles Burrell and Sons in 1864, and is therefore one of our oldest exhibits. After many years in use at Correll's farm in Saxonhurst, Kent, the traction engine was sold to the Soma Mining Corporation, where it was used on-site until the early 1930s, where it was sold for pleasure usage. Now part of the museum collection, it is currently displayed on Northeastern built 15-ton flat wagon number 55164. At the other end of the spectrum, this Avelingham Porter railway traction engine was built for work on light rail systems and for small-scale shunting operations, usually as a cheaper and more efficient alternative to full-size steam standard-gauge locomotive shunters. This example was used in various quarry sites during its lifetime, eventually being sold to the nearby Dexby Railway, who retain ownership of the locomotive and are loaning it to the Dark Railway as part of this exhibition. Built at Ashford Works in 1895, this locomotive was originally outshopped as a Southeastern Railway R-Class, designed by James Stirling. However, the engine was later rebuilt in 1913 to R1 specification by Harry Rainwright, the condition which is being preserved as seen here. The locomotive was used as a standard shunting locomotive on the Southeastern and Chatham Railway system until absorbed into the Southern Railway in 1923, where it was initially numbered A47, later 1047, continuing duties as a shunter and operational trip worker when necessary. Passing into British Railways ownership upon nationalisation, the engine was renumbered 31047 and allocated to station piloting and empty stock workings around the ex-Southeastern system, particularly at Dover and Ashford. Withdrawn from British Railway service in 1960 from Nine Elms Shed, the engine was among the last two R1s in service. Thankfully, two R1s have been saved, both by the nearby Dexby Railway. Number 31047 has been loaned to the museum, whilst the other, BR number 31128, remains based on the Dexby Railway in operational condition. Built in 1922 at Crewe Works, this impressive locomotive was designed by Charles Bowen Cook for heavy freight services on the London and North Western Railway. Classed as G2, this engine was originally numbered 13 by the London and North Western Railway, who used a strange numbering system for its locomotives. Once engines were built, the lowest number available was given to the locomotive, hence why number 13 was given to this locomotive. When the engine passed into London Midland and Scottish Railway service in 1923, it was given the number 9450 as part of a renumbering scheme to standardise the numbering sequence for the class, later gaining the number 49450 upon passing into British Railways ownership in 1948. After being run down and neglected for several years, number 49450 was withdrawn from service during 1959, being sold to a scrap merchant in the Birmingham area for scrapping. As fate would have it, number 49450 had been marshalled at the very back of the scrapyard, and survived in relatively intact condition until purchased by Lord Zeke Dark in 1972, being the final locomotive in the yard. After this, number 49450 was brought straight to the Dark Railway and immediately sent for display in the Railway Museum. It is currently in the condition that it was recovered, showing our visitors the condition of a steam locomotive at the end of its lifetime with British Railways. Fortunately, number 49450 is, mechanically speaking, in relatively good condition, and could potentially be restored to working order in the future when funds and time allow. Displayed with the locomotive is this four-wheeled oil tanker, built by Williams of Leeds in 1918 for crude oil traffic. It, too, has been preserved in well-worn condition alongside number 49450. One of our younger exhibits, number 3200, was built by the Great Western Railway Swindon Works in 1946, being part of the Collett 2251 class of goods engine, often nicknamed the Collett Goods. The locomotive worked for the Great Western Railway up until its absorption into British Railways in 1948, retaining its Great Western number of 3200, as all Great Western locomotives did. Allocated initially to Treventa Road Shed, number 3200 was used on the Brentwell branch line for general goods traffic for several years, before moving to Cardiff Canton Shed during the late 1950s, where it was noted as operating freight services as far as Worcester, Alfredston, Bristol, and Falmouth. During 1962, 3200 was reallocated to Gallen Junction upon the request of the Dark Railway, along with Great Western Railway 5600 class tank engine number 5670. Both locomotives were operated on trial, with number 3200 being selected for purchase by the railway after an accident at Mearcombe caused substantial damage to the 5600 tank engine. After many years of good service on the railway, number 3200 was withdrawn from service and placed into the care of the museum upon its opening. During its time with the museum, the engine has been in the care of the Dark Railway Preservation Society, who have volunteered to maintain the locomotive's aesthetic condition during its display period. The Society are currently in talks with the Dark Railway's owner, Lord Zeke Dark, regarding the option to eventually restore the locomotive to working order for use with the Society's operations. It has been preserved in the livery that it was outshopped from Swindon Works in 1946, Great Western Green with GWR emblem on the tender, with full brass fittings. It is displayed here with the Dark Railway Preservation Society owned Great Western Railway shunting wagon number 42020, restored in Great Western Grey livery. This display consists of two different types of wagon used in the transportation of milk on the railways of the United Kingdom. The first is pressurised milk tanker number 2549, a six-wheeled vehicle with a glass-lined tank, which was essential in preserving the freshness of milk being transported for distribution. These milk trains were run at higher speeds than regular goods trains, and as such, were provided with through braking equipment to allow these trains to run safely at high speeds. this example is painted in Express Dairy's livery. Also used for the transportation of dairy products is this Great Western Railway siphon G diagram van, numbered 1196. Whilst the milk tankers would have been filled fully with fresh milk in sterile tanks, the siphon G vans would have been filled with bottled glasses of milk for distribution from local stations at a much slower pace, though they would sometimes be marshalled with passenger trains. Once at a station, the van would be sidelined and the milk bottles removed for onward local distribution. This particular vehicle arrived on the railway along with the Dark Railway Preservation Society and was immediately used to replace a similar wagon for use on the Soma branch, which, as previously mentioned, does not enjoy good road transport. This van has a much higher capacity than the previous van and would be used to take fresh milk to the station at Soma Quarry, where the individual bottles would be distributed by local milkmen. It is painted in classic Great Western brown with GW on the sides. As mentioned, these milk trains would run at higher speeds or as part of passenger trains, meaning that they were piped through for braking reasons. However, this would not always eliminate the need for a brake van. Displayed with these vehicles is a typical example of a Great Western Railway 20-ton towed van with one large veranda at one end only, rather than the more common design with an open veranda at each end of the brake vehicle. Built for industrial use for the National Coal Board, number 2724, Goulburn, is a large outside-cylindered saddle tank built by the Robin Stevenson and Hawthorne Company in 1947. It was originally built for industrial use, but was later purchased by the National Coal Board for use at its colliery at Bedford, Lancashire. Named Goulburn after a local town, number 2724 put in many years of hard work at the colliery, being used to bring fully laden coal wagons from the pits to the main line exchange sidings. The engine worked right up to the end of operations at the colliery in 1967, being sold straight into preservation upon withdrawal for use on a start-up heritage line in Stoke. The locomotive, which had been restored to its elegant NCB lime maroon livery, is currently owned by a Mr. Kieran Rigby, who has asked us to display the locomotive in our museum whilst it awaits restoration to working order. One of our larger exhibits, alongside HMG Seam Shifter, is the railway 75-ton steam-powered breakdown crane. This crane was built by Cowans, Sheldon and Company of Carlisle in 1935, being used to re-rail railway vehicles that had suffered derailments or accidents. It was initially used by the London, Midland and Scottish Railway up until nationalisation, where the crane entered departmental service for British Railways. Purchased by the Dark Railway in 1963, the steam crane has been instrumental in the safety of the railway, often being used to re-rail locomotives and rolling stock after minor mishaps and accidents. It was also used for the heavy lifting jobs around the railway, being best known for heavy lifting jobs during the reconstruction and re-establishment of Coalhapper Motive Power Depot in the early 1970s. After suffering a burst steam tube, the crane was stored out of use until moved into the museum for display upon opening. It is preserved in British Railways departmental livery, along with associated runners and jib trucks. Our final exhibit is a unique survivor of the Great Western Railway, and has kindly been loaned to the Gallen Junction Railway Museum by the Redwick and Chiltern Hills Railway. Number 6803 is the only surviving example of a Great Western Railway Collett Grange class mixed traffic engine. They were versatile machines, often being used for a wide variety of trains on the Great Western Railway and, later, the Western region of British Railways. The class totaled 80 engines, which, despite their usefulness, had a high axle loading, meaning that they were banned from operating on lighter track work of branch lines on the system. For this reason, they were most often used on mainline services, hauling fast, perishable trains. Unfortunately, Only number 6803, Bucklebury Grange, survived the cutter's torch, being based on the Redwick and Chiltern Hills Preserved Railway, who have agreed to allow us to display the locomotive whilst it is out of service awaiting repairs to its front bogie assembly and springs. It is currently painted in British Railways lined green with early cycling line emblem on the tender. We hope that you have enjoyed your visit to the Gallen Junction Railway Museum. Feel free to continue browsing our exhibits, visit our gift shop and cafe, or visit our annex building for further information and exhibits.